Craig, what's your favourite Bond film?
Well, I'm going to be one of these cynical bastards. I'm going to say Live and Let Die.
Oh, my God.
No, you see, Live and Let Die is great.
No, it's not.
No, it's great.
It's not a Bond theme, but it grabs you by the ears and it repeatedly slams your head against the wall, and it's massive, it's huge, it explodes left, right and centre, it has a slight reggae beat, and then we get back into the explosion.
Craig, you're one of my dearest, closest friends, but...
Yeah, I'm sorry.
But
so this is the point where I prove to you, without a shadow of a doubt, that Live and Let Die is the worst Bond theme ever written. In fact, not even Bond theme, it's one of the worst pieces of music ever written, because it was written by someone with severe ADHD. You ready? Here we go. So we'll start and have it sound exactly like Imagine, that was released 2 years earlier by my old bandmate. Let's get the Bee Gees to do some backing vocals. Know some vocal histrionics? Now bring it down. More tension, more tension. Ridiculously big major chord for no reason. No Bond songs are in a major key. It's fucking moronic. Now I want the sound of skeletons running down the stairs. Now, a really irritating, piercing flute, but only in the left channel. I know what we need, tribal drum solo. And now, just atonal stabs of noise, please. And then have it build up somewhere. I've got the perfect idea. How about a reggae breakdown? Said nobody ever. What does it matter to you? And let's finish this with a cock rock scream vocal. Yeah. You got to give me other bell of hell. And also make sure the brass really farts on the right hand channel down at the bottom. Yeah.
He's laughing his own jokes. He's his own jokes.
I need some emotion. Cello solo, please. I couldn't be bothered to write another verse, so I just use the same one and slightly change the melody. Should we do that?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a nice idea. But if this ever-changing world in which we live in makes you offensive chimes. Live and let die. Haven't I heard this already? I'm sure they literally spliced the tape. Oh no, there's a fucking flute again. Farty brass. More offensive flutes. Ooh, bongo solo. Oh, and it also needs the sound of a scared elephant trumpeting. Oh, yeah, that's cool. Let's have an end to this song where it never feels like it fucking ends, because I want that to go on forever.